Hello students, welcome to Ajitaha IAS Academy and this is your Ravi Shankar. In this video, we will discuss about UNESCO Creative Cities Network. Whenever you are reading about any organization that is related with the United Nations, the first thing we need to remember is the goal of all the United Nations organizations is achieving the sustainable development. But how they try to achieve that changes with respect to the goal of the or the strategy of the particular organization. For example, if it is UNESCO, they want to achieve the sustainable development by attaining peace, by using art and culture and creativity as means to achieve the sustainable development. As Gandhiji rightly said, means is important than ends to achieve the goals. UNESCO tries to achieve the sustainable development of peace through culture and creativity and education and scientific and so other aspects. Okay. So when we are dealing with UNESCO, there are so many initiatives, and one of the initiatives is the Creative Cities Network. So it focuses on the cities where those cities which invest in the culture and creativity as accelerators to achieve the sustainable development. Simple. And when it is created? It is created in 2004. To remember the years, whether UPSC will ask this question as years is questionable. However, you can also use this logic to remember the years in other aspects also. Whenever you want to try to remember the years related with some other aspect, 2004 is related to general elections in India, where there is a transformative change in the government. That is, UPA came into power for almost 10 years. Many of us know whatever it had did. So it is like a kind of a creativity in economic policy also. Whether it brought fruits or not, it is questionable. But let's not discuss into the critical aspect. Rather, to remember 2004, it came. Okay. And all these other facts you can read. But the important aspect to remember the in the case of prelims is only 6 Indian cities have been in the list of almost more than 295 cities. India is a cradle of civilizations. However, only 6 cities in India have been selected to the list. And recently it is the Srinagar that was selected among the 49 cities among the world in the category of crafts and folk arts category. However, there are 7 categories in which this Creative Cities Network chooses the cities. This list, just read, but it won't be asked in the mains examination. And the different cities have been selected for different things. But the critical analysis, what you can do in case of mains also is, our cities and our priorities have been moving towards the Western civilization. But if you try to bring the culture of our Indian civilization into the cities, we can create more jobs and we can transform our cities landscape towards building a sustainable cities. So we can create jobs in such a way that traditional folk art and culture of our country and the people, most of the people are migrating from the rural to cities in search of employment, leaving their family traditions and leaving their family professions. But if you bring these culture and creativity into the cities, coupling with modern technology, we can create more jobs in a new field, in a newer, we can create new jobs also. But when we don't do that, these people who are masters in the culture and art, they are working as bartenders and those kind of jobs where their art is being misused, where the talent is being misused. So we can give that kind of a critical analysis in mains and essays, but we will give more analysis later. So the point is 2004 and cities, there are 6 cities: Chennai, Varanasi, Jaipur, Mumbai, Hyderabad and Srinagar in the folk and art category. These are raw facts, but we need to focus on these 6 cities. What are the cultural aspects in those cities? And those questions have been asked in the previous years also. Because if you come to Chennai, there are certain questions related to the Chennai and those regions which are close to Chennai also. such as Mahabalipuram, they have asked very important questions regarding the temples and art in the prelims. So we need to do that kind of a strategy. We are making videos on those aspects also, notes is also ready. So Creative Cities Network is UNESCO. This is important. Another aspect is United Nations World Trade Organization's Best Tourism Village. So if you come to village, it is UNWTO, not UNESCO. And their objective is different. We will discuss about that in the next video. So keep watching and please like, comment and subscribe. Thank you so much.